Oh. Oh.
Hello everyone, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. We're back with the rifle round chain reaction. And if you don't remember what we did the first time, this is where we use a BB gun to ignite the primer of the first round and set off a chain reaction through 11 rifle rounds, 5.56 rifle rounds to be specific, on our test rig here. This time we'll be using the Chronos high-speed camera. For this first shot, I set the Chronos camera to 5,000 frames per second. And this is roughly 4 times faster than when we filmed it with our other cameras. And still, the event happened extremely fast. Now here I've slowed it down in the editor about 4 times. And still, it's going very fast. But we get a better idea what's going on. We can see the energy wave just screaming down that tube. Okay, let's check out the damage.
These are all of our shards. This is what our forensic team has found so far. Some blasted out tube. Look at that, how that brass just pedaled out of there. This, we think, is the very first round. Some powder burns, and it seated the bullet down in the neck. Might be able to see all of the powder that blasted around this. This gummy bear was all completely clear. And we've got a huge brass shard in here.
Oh,
ouch.
Is it backwards somehow?
He had a bullet seated in his belly, barely touching his belly when we started. For viewer Fat Shadow, by the way, who likes our folding knife component, carrying the Columbia River knife and tool M16 14M today. Shout out to Fat Shadow.
Now, 5,000 frames per second definitely wasn't fast enough. I was trying to find a good compromise between resolution and frame rate, but let's crank it up to 10,000 frames per second. Okay, let's see what the Chronos high-speed camera captured. Now, even at 10,000 frames per second, this event is happening extremely fast. It looks like we had a complete chain reaction, and I even saw a bullet come out the front of the gummy bear. Let's watch it again here. The neat thing about the Chronos camera is you can adjust the resolution both height and by width. So I stole a little bit of the width and applied it to the height, giving me a little taller shot, just so we could see more debris flying in the field. Now we were going to do one more shot at 22,000 frames per second, but in this shot it actually broke the BB gun. Now in order to visualize the speed of the energy wave, let's compare it to a 40 Smith & Wesson bullet. That bullet is traveling about 1,050 feet per second, and it looks like it's very close to the same speed as our energy wave. And next we'll compare it to an AK-47 bullet, and you can see that the bullet is much faster. So the energy wave is probably going about the speed of sound, which is still very fast.
You can actually see the damage in several different places here where each of those rounds really dug in.
Yeah, that was all nicely painted. That.
And then of course, Mr. Gummy took another gunshot to the back. I don't know if there's anything in him this time, but that is a gruesome looking wound on the outside.
Anything in there?
Just a lot of powder. It has been, actually, the powder's been just shoved right up in it. Look at
wow,
that.
I bet there's a bullet in there or
there's
something.
A straight line.
Yeah, something like, was carried through it.
Like powder injection, which is the name of my retro 80s band.
And for those of you who have absolutely no interest in this video other than wanting to know what the music is, there you go. I want to thank Laura Pratt for letting me use her awesome song for this video. Hey, when you get there, tell her TAOFLEDERMAUS sent you. Thanks for watching.